And then finally, after the chorus is repeated twice, she says this little extra bridge that says, si aún piensas algo en mí, sabes que sigo esperándote. Si aún piensas algo en mí, sabes que sigo esperándote. Now, this is a short bridge, but it's full of nice things to explain in Spanish. The word si means if. Let me just say this as well. You might have been thinking that si means yes. Well, there's a slight difference between si meaning if and si meaning yes. The word si, spelt S-I with an accent on the I, means yes. Whereas si, spelt S-I with no accent on the I, means if. They're pronounced in the same way and they look very similar, but they mean yes when there's an accent and if when there's no accent. Anyway, so she says, si aún piensas algo en mí. The word aún means still in Spanish, and piensas means you think. Piensas comes from the verb pensar, meaning to think. And when you put en after any form of pensar, you get to think about. So piensas en mí means you think about me. Let me just also take this opportunity to explain here the difference between me and me. Me, spelt M-I with no accent, means my. Whereas me, spelt M-I with an accent on the I, means me. For example, es para mí. Es para mí means it's for me. Whereas es para mi hermano. Es para mi hermano means it's for my brother. So me with an accent means me, and me with no accent means my. You might be thinking, what about the Spanish word me, which we've already seen when she said things like cambiándome? Well, there are two ways to say me in Spanish. We've seen me, spelt M-I with an accent, but there's also me. You use me with verbs, and you use me with prepositions. Prepositions are words like para, a, de, por, en, etc. With all those words, you use me. For example, para mí means for me. A mí means to me. De mí means from me. Por mí means because of me. En mí means on me. So they're all prepositions. With any verbs, however, you always use me to say me. For example, me entiendes. Me entiendes means do you understand me? Me molestas. Me molestas means you're annoying me. Molestas means you are annoying. María me odia. María me odia means Maria hates me. So you put the me in front of the verb. Me envió esta carta. Me envió esta carta means she sent me this letter. Anyway, back to the song. The word algo in Spanish means something, but it can also mean anything. So when Shakira sings, si aún piensas algo en mí, she means if you still think anything about me. So si aún, if still, piensas, you think, algo en mí, something or anything about me. I think in English, we would probably say something a bit more like this. If you still think about me at all. So si aún piensas algo en mí, if you still think about me at all. And then she goes on to say, sabes que sigo esperándote. Sabes que sigo esperándote. We saw at the beginning of the song, sé que, which means I know that, when she said sé que no vendrás, I know that you won't come. Well, sabes que means you know that, sabes que. And she says, sabes que sigo esperándote. Well, sigo comes from the verb seguir, which normally means to follow. However, there is an interesting thing about the verb seguir. You can put a present participle, which is the ing version of the verb, after seguir to show that you carry on doing something. Remember that the present participle in Spanish ends in ando or yendo. So, for example, you could say, sigo aprendiendo español. Sigo aprendiendo español means I carry on learning Spanish, or I continue learning Spanish. So, aprender means to learn. Aprendiendo is learning. So, seguir is the verb it comes from. Let me give you the present tense of the verb seguir, because I think it's quite a useful verb. So, sigo means I carry on, I continue, or I follow. Sigues means you carry on, you continue, or you follow. Sigue, or él sigue, means he carries on, he continues, or he follows. Ella sigue means she carries on, she continues, or she follows. The él and ella in él sigue and ella sigue are both optional, and they're only there if you need to put them there to clarify the difference between he and she. So if you're speaking about just he, then you probably don't need to use él. Whereas if it could be a little bit unclear as to whether you're talking about he or she, you can add the words él or ella. And in fact, you can put él or ella anywhere in the sentence. They haven't got to go right in front of the verb. Then seguimos. Seguimos means we carry on, or we continue, or we follow. And then siguen means they carry on, they continue, or they follow. So that's the present tense of seguir. Sigo, sigues, él sigue, ella sigue, seguimos, siguen. So by itself, seguir means to follow. For example, me siguen means they're following me. Me siguen. Or you could say, sigo un curso de español por Kieran Ball, which means I'm following a Spanish course by Kieran Ball. Sigo un curso. I'm following a course. Or you could ask, ¿a quién sigues? ¿A quién sigues? Which means, whom are you following? Whereas if you put a present participle on the end of any form of seguir, then it means to carry on doing something or to continue doing something. In English, you can also use it to show that you're still doing something, and then you don't need to use the word for still in Spanish. So for example, él sigue buscando trabajo. You can say that means he's still looking for work. It literally means he's carrying on looking for work, or he's continuing looking for work. But in English, you can say he's still looking for work. Sigo viviendo aquí. I'm still living here. ¿Por qué sigues esperando a María? Means why are you still waiting for Maria? Seguimos decidiendo. We're still deciding. Seguimos decidiendo. Sigue lloviendo. Sigue lloviendo means it's still raining. So Shakira says, sigo esperándote. The verb esperar means to wait, and the te on the end means you. So sigo esperándote means I'm still waiting for you. In Spanish, you don't ever say waiting for somebody, you just say waiting somebody or something. For example, espero el autobús. Espero el autobús means I'm waiting for the bus, but in Spanish there's no word for here. If you think of it more like awaiting rather than waiting for, it's easier to get your head round. So espero el autobús, I'm awaiting the bus. Esperamos el tren, we're awaiting the train. So anyway, the last bridge of the song goes, si aún piensas algo en mí, sabes que sigo esperándote, which means if you still think about me at all, you know that I'm still waiting for you. And that's it. That's the whole song. So I hope this helped. She goes on then to sing the chorus two or three more times. But let's just have a quick look through all the song, and I'll tell you what it means all the way through. So, ya sé que no vendrás. I already know that you won't come. Todo lo que fue, El tiempo lo dejó atrás. Everything that was, time left it behind. Sé que no regresarás. I know that you won't come back. Lo que nos pasó no repetirá jamás. What happened to us won't happen again. Mil años no me alcanzarán para borrarte y olvidar. 1,000 years won't be enough in order for me to erase you and forget. Y ahora estoy aquí, queriendo convertir los campos en ciudad, mezclando el cielo con el mar. And now I'm here, wanting to turn the fields into a city, mixing up the sky with the sea. Sé que te dejé escapar. Sé que te perdí. I know that I let you escape. I know that I lost you. Nada podrá ser igual. Nothing can be the same. Mil años pueden alcanzar para que puedas perdonar. 1,000 years can be enough so that you might be able to forgive. Estoy aquí queriéndote. I'm here wanting you. Ahogándome entre fotos y cuadernos. Drowning in photos and notebooks. Entre cosas y recuerdos que no puedo comprender. Amongst things and memories that I can't understand. Estoy enloqueciéndome. I'm driving myself crazy. Cambiándome un pie por la cara mía, esta noche por el día, y nada le puedo yo hacer. Changing a foot for my face, this night for the day, and I can do nothing about it. Las cartas que escribí nunca las envié. No querrás saber de mí. The letters that I wrote, I never sent them. You won't want to know about me. No puedo entender lo tonta que fui. Es cuestión de tiempo y fe. I can't understand how stupid I was. It's a matter of time and faith. Mil años con otros mil más son suficientes para amar. 1,000 years with 1,000 more are enough to love. And then she sings the chorus again. And the little bridge in the middle goes, Si aún piensas algo en mí, sabes que sigo esperándote. If you still think about me at all, you know that I'm still waiting for you. The end.